Well, you know, another pro day, you know, my fourth here at Pitt, which is nice to be back for fourth one. And, you know, all 32 teams were represented today, so I think it was a great showing. I think our kids did a great job. At times we have to slow down the scouts so they don't beat our guys up. You know, it's still my job to protect our guys. They wanted to get some good looks at it, but overall, just watching our kids work, compete, impressive by them.
Is there anybody here that you thought really had the most to sort of gain from going through this, or the most to improve their stock from the team?
Yeah, obviously Jordan Whitehead. You know, he went away to train. I don't know what happened there. I think if he had trained with Dave Andrews, you know, he probably wouldn't have got hurt. But he had a hammy and went to the combine in Indianapolis. Didn't get a chance to do much there. I think he posted a 4.5 in the 40, which is important for him to test. So I think probably that was the guy. I think Alex Officer did some great things today as well. You know, guys, you look at the guys that didn't go to the combine; those are the guys that have stuff to prove. Quadra Henderson had a shot to come out here and do some good things and catch some punts and show what he has that way. So I mean, anybody that didn't go to the combine has an opportunity. Ryan Winslow, I mean, he's a combine guy that came out here, probably five special teams coordinators in the NFL here to watch him punt, and are very, very impressed with Ryan.
Did you get Quadra's 40 time?
I did. You know, I've heard somewhere, high 4.3s, 4.5s. You know, everybody's got a different watch. So I'd say probably 4.4 is where most people have it, flat. So it's fast.
Now, do you talk to coaches? The team's asking me about, about this kid off the field, how they are.
Can I just do that? Just in general, I mean, what's your feedback? Jordan said,
yeah, I mean, we talked to them, but they do enough research. I mean, those NFL teams, they know what's going on. They do their homework. I mean, they're connected, whether it's someone in Pittsburgh, someone in, Nevada, or someone in Texas. I mean, they do their homework. They find out what they need to find out. But, if they ask a question, we're going to give an answer.
What kind of feedback did you get before you went out?
You mean back when he declared? His family, he's got a great support system at home, and we talk about the advantages and disadvantages, and I think Jordan was ready to go to the next level, and I think that's something that he wanted to do, and it's been his dream. He's had, three great years here, whether he plays offense or defense. He's a superb football player. I think he can play both ways, and I think it's to his advantage that he's able to play and take snaps on offense, even freshman year against Notre Dame, and those cut-ups still come up in the NFL. So he's impressive. He's a super, super person. Love his family, and I'm happy for him.
Quadra was the other three-year junior who made that decision. And did you think he was ready, and what did you sort of tell him about improving his?
First thing, it's not my job to say if he's ready or not, so it doesn't matter. It's when he's ready and his family's ready, and that's what they thought. I think everybody, unless you're going to be a first or second rounder, should stay. But that's for them to decide, so that's kind of how that goes.
What do you think he needs to show teams in terms of, I mean, everyone knows what he can do return-wise, but receiving-wise, what are the biggest things he needs to?
Well, I think he needs to prove that he's a receiver, and I think that's what these workouts are for. I think that's what the combine was for. He's obviously a talented athlete that he's got to show that he can be a great receiver, too. Obviously another year would help that happen, as far as getting down the field, or maybe it wouldn't. Who knows? We've worked on it for 3 years, so he's just, incredible, one of the best in the country as far as a return guy, especially so if someone needs that, he's going to go high.
Does it amaze you how time flies? I mean, we can remember these Jordan and company coming in as freshmen, same year as you, and now they're...
It means I'm getting really old. My hair is thinning out. You get old when you watch these guys come in as freshmen, and you have a part in recruiting them, and then to see them go out, it's really their last time getting to wear Pitt gear. That's why we put them out, dress them nice, and it's kind of their going away present. We had a nice lunch yesterday just to kind of film in on the day, get their input on what they needed, how much time they needed to show what they had to do. So, it's sad, but we're happy for them in the future.
Yeah, I mean, as a coach, would you like to see third-year players that come out be given a larger window in terms of being fully committed, or is that putting too much havoc in the program? Like the Pac-12 came out and said, basketball said, hey, we should let guys sign, and if they don't get drafted or they can come back way late. I'm talking like June.
I think that'd be that'd be a great idea. We don't get to make those decisions, but if you don't get drafted, you should have the opportunity to come back. The only problem is they move recruiting up, so we're trying to make our decisions. You're signing guys in December, and these guys have to know, so you need to know how many scholarships you have. It's hard to recruit, so, one way, I think it'd be great for the kids to be able to have that opportunity to come back if things don't work out. Every year, there's more and more kids that leave early and don't get drafted, and that's the scary part, especially when you do it without having a degree. I mean, Brian O'Neill is not a risk because he's got his degree. So you can understand his, and his stock has risen, I think. And there's a lot of people talking about him in the first round right now. If not, you know, high second round pick, and he's going to make a lot of money, so it's a great thing.
You've been calling Abate an NFL guy for a long time. You feel like other people are sort of finally starting to see that after how challenging some of his responsibilities were here over the years?
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. He's a competitor. He's a leader. You know, you love that guy to death. He'd give you everything he had every Saturday. But not only every Saturday, but every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, in the film room, on the field. You know, I won't mention any NFL teams, but there's his stock has continued to go up because of his work ethic and really what he did, his resumes, what he's done on video. And, you know, NFL guys ask me, hey, what do you think of Avonte Maddox? You know, he's one of the best I've been around. And I don't just say that. Two other first-rounders, Darquez Dennard, Trey Waynes, that guy fits right in that same mold with those two guys. Whether he gets drafted or not, first round, who knows, but that's for them to decide. But he's a football player, and I, you know, if I had to draft three corners, I'd draft all three of those guys. How about that? And I think he's really, you know, would not shock me if he goes high.